Hey everyone, I'm gonna review over this video, and also I'm gonna be talking about a couple other things. Do want to point out that he does have bots on his YouTube channel, posting some rather weird stuff, but also it explains why his likes have gone up from his normal dislike to like ratio. Most of the time he gets way more dislikes than likes, and I can prove this just by showing you. Video has 7,000 likes and 6,500 dislikes. That was his most recent video. Unsure if there's bots or not involved with that. But I do want to point on the video that there was bots, which this is a beautiful place that this video is paused at. But there is more likes than dislikes, which is rather unusual for a Mini Lad video, especially recently. The video right before the video that's accused to have a lot of bots on it has 8,500 likes and 19,000 dislikes. This is also the disgusting video I watched for the 24 hours. And if you guys think, oh, that video is just disgusting, that's why it has more dislikes than likes. Okay, then let's go to the video before that. 17,000 dislikes and 9,300 likes. Oh, you don't want to take that one into consideration either? The video before that has 17,000 dislikes and 8,900 likes. So my point is proven that his most recent video, videos that are actually funny, that the video that is accused to have a lot of bots on it, has more likes than dislikes. Now it's only 1,000 more likes, but there's a lot more likes on that video than a normal Mini Lad video would have. The view rate is just about the same, so there shouldn't be a huge influx in likes compared to dislikes. It should normally be right around the same or at a steady decline, but that one video is a little bit more liked than disliked. And I just want to point out that this is confirming that something is happening, and I do have proof here that there are bots on his channel and on this video. So hopefully he isn't using bots in some sort of way just to get better comments and to get more likes, but it is a possibility. Also, I want to mention that he's pulled out of the whole Thirst Project thing. Thought that was interesting. And any other sponsorships or anything else that ends up maybe happening, he'll probably not be able to have the opportunity to do those. Like I said before, his Cove Audio sponsor has been pulled away because of a fan getting a hold of them on Twitter and letting them know, and Cove pulled their sponsorship from his video, which he was forced to take that video down. But let's see what we can review in this video.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for war. Out of the years that I've been doing Reddit videos.
Yeah, he probably won't be able to do Reddit videos anymore. And it's kind of apparent he won't be able to, because a lot of other people would be going to the Reddit and just flooding stuff that is pedo related. Or talking about the situation at least, trying to get him to address it.
Welcome to r/Photoshop Battles.
So for him to go to other subreddits, this makes sense because he won't be able to have a Reddit of his own. But again, I wouldn't necessarily put anything Reddit related, especially pulling up other Reddits, because it would be kind of sad if people went to these Reddits and they were able to post on these Reddits just because you made a video about it. Now let's hope this doesn't happen. Don't be going to flood other Reddits just because Mini uses another Reddit. But if it does end up happening, I hope Mini learns from this and learns not to pull up other stuff like this. He could just be pulling up the images and not be shouting out the Reddit altogether. And the only reason why I say this is because negative connotations with him and other subreddits isn't the best thing for him to have. And what I mean by this is, since he has a bad image and a bad reputation, him pulling up any other YouTube content creators, Reddits, or websites, or anything where fans can go and post on those, there's now going to be a huge battle/war there on people defending Mini and people not defending Mini. And it kind of sucks all the way around that stuff like this has to happen, but it's just the nature of the internet. So I hope in the future he doesn't tie other things to him.
Save rule bad puns later.
Now, he's been using those, like, SpongeBob time card things, but they have some weird accent over them. I don't think that's funny at all. I just want to point out that Mini's probably still editing his videos, and this just shows the huge difference between Ty and him as an editor. Having Mini Lad have his own editor was important to him because there was a level of quality in the videos, and I feel like his quality has severely dipped ever since.
Long suit, but I shall see you in a bit.
Another Irish accent? Let's see what Simp has to say about this in the comment section below.
Kind of looks like a space helmet. And I was like, oh, or Among Us. Maybe I'll just keep saying Among Us for the algorithm. Among Us, Imposter, Wires, Corpse, Sykuno, Names. Thank you, algorithm. Big fan.
Oh, so this just sort of proves that he's trying to write off the success of Among Us. It ain't like he's going to ever be able to find a group to play Among Us with because of the poor reception he'll probably get to the other group members that he would play with. So, yeah, Mini's toast in terms of uploading Among Us content and banking off the success off of that. So obviously he's just going to clickbait his videos, have Among Us characters in the thumbnail, and talk about the Among Us things, And he just sort of proved that, oh yeah, I might as well mention Among Us in one of my videos, and this is going to be an opportunity for him to do that. Now, some of you guys might be thinking, oh, it's not that big of a deal or anything, which it's not, but it just sort of proves that Mini ain't going to be able to do this type of stuff, and obviously he's going to do what he can to appease to those people being like, oh, something Among Us related in this video, when really, he's just doing it so more people can click on his videos, because he's going to need all the support and help he can. Which I don't know if it would bring any help and support, but I just wanted to point that out.
This one came out so much better than I expected. All right, well, that being said, let us see the challengers.
Keep photoshopping, keep doing what you gotta do to get Among Us in your videos, because you're probably gonna be one of the only YouTube channels out there who does not play Among Us, but yet puts so much Among Us content in your videos, when the video is not at all about the game. That's probably the only award you can win. Most non-Among Us player, but still puts Among Us in his videos. Even I put up more Among Us videos than you, and you're considered a gaming channel. Way before I'm considered a gaming channel. Alright, let's go.
Nick Cage, what's he do himself? Random fact that you're never gonna do anything with in life, but I have the same birthday as Nick Cage. That's right, I'm 53 years old.
Wait, you're 53? The allegations look so much more sus now.
Stretch him! Stretch out the old muscles!
Ah! Those sweat marks. Are you really that nervous when it comes to video making? I mean, if I was in your situation, I'd be nervous too.
You can't let yourself down. Schlatt and I are gonna come back in 2024 and show the world why we deserve to be president of the United States of America. I still need to figure it out myself, but you know, we'll get to work. We'll get chop.
It's kind of weird after I've just made my 2024 presidential election video and I just put merch of my own on my merch website, which you should go check that in the description below. But it's kind of weird that he just mentioned himself being president.
For me, just in case there are people who are going to get offended by this, I am not American. I could get away with this. I'm a foreigner laughing from afar.
You are not an American, so you can get away with it. Is that what you said when all these allegations were attacking you? Ugh. Because you're from another country doesn't mean you can get away with anything. You're still a content creator, and a big portion of your audience is from America. You know this. There wasn't really much to say about it. The video's just cringy. I'm burnt out from the whole Minilab thing, but I'll still do it because I said I was going to do it, and you guys are expecting me to make a Minilab video. A lot of you guys were DMing me and telling me to do it during my 24-hour live stream, which, by the way, thank you for coming to the 24-hour live stream, but I do want to point out, it was pretty challenging to get through that, and watching this video is even more challenging after the whole fact. So I just wanted to point out, Mini's video is still cringy. There's a few things that I broke down and talked about, but for the most part, the video's cringy, and I expect all you guys to pretty much just forget about Mini and move on from it. But anyways, guys, that's the video. Hope you guys enjoyed, and hopefully some of you guys have some new information for you about the whole Mini thing. I did put the whole video breakdown and the whole bots and Thirst Project thing all in one video, because I thought it was important just to put everything in one video and cover all of it at the same time, so I'm not making six videos a week about Minilad. But yeah, if there's any other Minilad information, you can obviously let me know in the comment section, or you can get a hold of me through Discord and put it in the YouTuber Rants text channel, and I will surely be able to take a peek at that and make a video about it if it's worthy making a video for. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys all next time. Peace.